Hey everybody, it's Eric with Takedown Nation. Today we're going to talk about part three of the Underhook and the Gi series. So, like we talked about before, I grab my opponent's collar, I go for his wrist. He pulls that back. That's my opportunity to step in for the underhook. Once I've got the underhook, my first move, drop straight down for the single. Isn't usually going to work, he's going to kick this leg back. Right back up to that underhook. Now, the second part of it was where I block his knee, push him across it, throw him across. So today, we're going to talk about what happens when that knee tap misses. If I go for his knee, he's going to step that leg back. Now, if you look here, my left leg is far back, my right leg is closer, so I'm going to step in with my left leg to get momentum to put a shoulder check right into his side. As I body lock, and I'm going to wrap that leg there. So I come from here to here. It's important, in order to keep your opponent's and your partner's knee safe, is to really explode through that. The worst thing that I can do here is that when I come in, if I hang and drag, that's all that weight on his ankle, I have a higher risk of injuring him than I do when I come in for real. See how I keep my hips square and flat, the legs tucked underneath. So one more time, through the whole series. I grab, I go for the sleeve, he pulls it back. Underhook, near leg, nope. Far leg, nope. Step in, body lock. It's one of my favorite sequences in the gi. I hope you work on it, enjoy it. Takedown Nation.